Hello everyone, what is up? Welcome back. Let me dive straight into it. The case I'm going to be talking about today is called the Toa Payoh Ritual Murders, which took place in 1981. So this is a story about two children getting brutally raped and murdered by this psychotic guy who wanted to derail police officers from his rape charges. So on the afternoon of 24th January 1981, 9-year-old Agnes Ng Siew Hock disappeared after attending religious classes at her church in Toa Payoh. Hours later, her naked body was found, curled up in a fetal position and stuffed in a bag outside a lift in Block 11, less than a kilometer from the church. The girl had been raped and smothered to death. On the 6th of February 1981, almost 2 weeks after Agnes's death, 10-year-old Ghazali bin Marzuki went missing after visiting his grandmother. He had gone downstairs to play with his two cousins, but left with a woman in a taxi who asked him to help her with some errands. The next day, his naked body was found dead under a tree between blocks 10 and 11. His cause of death was drowning, and he also possessed suffocation marks similar to those on Agnes's. There were no signs of sexual assault, but there were burns on the boy's back and a puncture on his arm. Traces of a sedative were later detected in his blood. So this is where the murder is fucked up. During investigations, the police found a scattered trail of blood that led to the 7th floor of Block 12. Following the trail of blood, it led the inspectors into a common corridor where there was a mix of religious symbols, mainly a cross, mirror, and a knife blade on the entrance of the first unit. The owner of the flat was Adrian Lim, and in the house, there were two other women present, his wife, Catherine Tan Wei Chu, and his holy wife, who is basically just his mistress, Ho Ka Hong. They were quickly investigated. Okay, so let's go into the background of the suspects. So the main suspect, Adrian Lim, was actually a self-taught spirit medium. So if you guys don't know what a medium is, it's basically a person that uses his or her psychic or intuitive abilities to see the past, present and future events of a person by tuning into the spirit energy surrounding that person. So basically a scam lah. I mean, I don't know how true it is, but I never believe in these things. So what Adrian basically does is that he lies to his clients with like several confidence tricks. So his most effective gimmick is actually called the eggs and needles trick. This trick actually led a lot of people to believe that he has supernatural powers. So basically what he does is that he will blacken needles with soot from a burning candle and then carefully insert them into a raw egg and seal the hole with powder. So basically during the rituals, he will pass several eggs over his clients and ask the clients to open the eggs. Because the clients are unaware that the eggs has been tampered with, they will believe that the sight of black needles means that evil spirits were harassing them. So Adrian usually preyed on gullible girls who had deep personal problems. He promised them that he could solve all their woes and increase their beauty through a ritual massage. So after Adrian and his client had stripped, he would knead her body, including her genitals, and have sex with her. His treatments also included an electroshock therapy used on mental patients. Oh my god, I can't believe people are actually falling for it. Like, why would you want to receive pain like that, you know? He assured the clients that the shocks would like cure headaches and drive away evil spirits. The second suspect, his wife, Catherine Tan Wei Chu. She used to be a bar girl who was then introduced to Adrian by her colleague. At the time, she was grieving the death of her grandmother and poured her heart out to Adrian. So their relationship soon grew intimate, and in 1975, she moved into his flat. In June 1977, they registered their marriage. Adrian was emotionally, physically and verbally abusive in the marriage. He also managed to persuade Catherine to sell her body to supplement their income. Not only that, he convinced her that he needed to have sex with young women to stay healthy. Catherine promised her that if she had sex with younger boys, it would preserve her beauty and make her live longer or some shit. And she actually slept with a Malay teenager and with her own younger brother. Despite all these abuses, Catherine actually stayed with him because they were generating great income, and like she was spending it on dresses, beauty products and like slimming products. So basically she's blinded by money. Third suspect, Ho Ka Hong, Adrian's holy wife, aka mistress, first met Adrian in 1979 when her mother brought her to seek treatment from Adrian, hoping to cure her temper. Ka Hong quickly became one of Adrian's loyal followers as she was convinced of his supernatural power. Adrian then desired to make her one of his holy wives, even though she was already married at that time to Benson Low. To achieve this goal, Adrian actually isolated her from her family by feeding her lies and claiming that her family were immoral people who practiced infidelity, and that her husband at that time, Benson, was an unfaithful man who would force her into prostitution. Ka Hong believed his words, turned violent towards her mother and moved out of her house to live with Adrian. On the the 7th of January 1980, Benson went to look for her at Adrian's apartment, but ended up staying to observe her treatments. He was then persuaded by her to participate in electroshock therapy, where they both sat with their feet in separate tubs of water and their arms linked together. Adrian then applied a large voltage to Benson, who got electrocuted, while Ka Hong was stunned into unconsciousness. When she woke up, Adrian told her to lie about Benson's death. They came out of this whole story saying that her husband has been electrocuted when he tried to switch on a faulty electric fan in the dark. That's not the worst, you know. The coroner actually recorded an open verdict and police made no further investigations. An open verdict is basically when the jury finds that the death is suspicious but is unable to reach any other verdicts. Also, it was said that after this, Ka Hong felt really guilty by Benson's death, that she started hearing voices and hallucinating her dead husband and was admitted to the hospital diagnosed with schizophrenia. But she actually made a quick recovery and was discharged from the hospital after a month. So back to the investigations. Police found this trail of blood to his apartment, right? So they decided to search his house. So when they searched his house, they actually found a drop of blood in the kitchen floor. And Adrian actually tried to pass the stains off as candle wax, but later changed his words, claiming that they were chicken blood. The police also found slips of paper written with the dead children's personal details in the apartment. Adrian retorted, claiming that Ghazali had come to his flat seeking a treatment for a bleeding nose. Adrian then discreetly removed hair from under a cupboard and tried to flush it down the toilet, but the police stopped him. Forensics later determined the hair to be Agnes Ng's. The police then requested a background check on Adrian and received word that he was currently involved in a rape investigation. Adrian actually overheard them and became really agitated, and he started like shouting at the law enforcers. Carl also started gesturing violently and started shouting at the officers. The police then collected the evidence, sealed the flat as a crime scene, and took Adrian and the two women in for questioning. So basically, this guy was investigated for a rape charge and he wanted to derail police officers, so he killed two children instead, hoping that they won't look into his case anymore. So this is what apparently happened. On the 19th of October in the late 1980s, Lucy Lau charged Adrian Lim with rape. She was a sales girl who met him when she was promoting beauty products. Adrian told Lucy that a ghost was hunting her, but he could help her with his sex rituals. He mixed two capsules of Delmadom, a sedative, into a glass of milk and offered it to her, claiming it has holy properties. Adrian took advantage of her that day. The following weeks, he continued to abuse her using drugs and threats. 2 months later, Lucy made a police report and Adrian was arrested. That was when he started to plot the murders in order to like distract the police. Adrian pretended to be possessed by Kali and convinced both his wife and his mistress that the goddess wanted them to kill children to get revenge on Lucy. On each occasion, Ka Hong, the mistress, actually lured a child to Adrian's flat where she was drugged and killed by the trio. Adrian then sexually assaulted Agnes after lacing her food with sedative before killing her, first smothering her with a pillow and then drowning her in a pail of water. Oh my god, fucking brutal. Not only that, he finished off by electrocuting her to make doubly sure that she's dead. Ghazali was also lured by Ka Hong, however he was resistant to the sedatives, so Adrian decided to tie up the boy as a precaution. However, the boy woke up and struggled. The trio then delivered karate chops to his neck to stun him. So that's literally what Wikipedia said. Karate chop. I know it's a defense move to punch someone's nose up like this and then they will faint, right? But karate chops? Like what? Oh shit, the poor boy, he struggled, vomited, and lost control of his bowels as he died. Blood kept streaming from his nose after his death. Catherine, the wife, stayed behind to clean the flat while Adrian and Ka Hong, the mistress, disposed of the body. They actually noticed the trail of blood that led to his flat, and they tried to clean up as much of the stains before sunrise, but they didn't do a good job obviously. That's why it led police to their flat. The trio were then charged with murder and were hanged on the 25th of November in 1988. So yeah, that's all for this case. Do you think they deserve the death penalty, or maybe he was struggling with something mental inside of him, that's why he decided to kill? Like, the fuck kills children just because he wants to derail from his rape charge? It's just like adding more crimes to his list, you know? Alright, if you guys don't know, I actually have a main channel where I do travel and lifestyle vlogs, and it will be linked in the description below, so please subscribe. See you in the next one. Bye!